Good morning, it's Saturday the 3rd of October. My earliest memories focus on gardens. One of them was the garden and the grounds of St Ernan's, a hotel in Donegal. It was one of those hotels where various clergy families spent summer holiday weeks. I think it was a reduced price if you were one of the clergy. I can't really remember. I was only four when I first went there. Older parishioners will remember the Lockharts, who were with us guests at St Ernan's. They lived here in Carriedhoff Rectory when it was first built. Norman and his young family stayed at St Ernan's, having been the best of friends with Harold Larry, my dad, and our families were close in those days. Looking at the image today, there doesn't seem to be much room for grounds, but to a four-year-old like me, it was huge. And there was a unique aroma of the plants that hung around beneath the tree cover over to the left of the picture. There were paths behind and beside the hotel that led to the little mooring to the left of the building, and a grassy slope which led up to the veranda, and the glass-covered stairway leading to the entrance porch. Memories of that garden are vivid, and some of the family photographs in the old albums reflect those times. I wonder how others who were there would remember it. The Woodheads, the Wrights, the Lockharts, the Williams families. I'm sure they all recall something different. But I'm sure they would remember something of St Ernan's, the hotel at the end of the causeway just outside Donegal town. Our reading today is about a garden, a place called Gethsemane. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and Jesus said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took Peter, James, and John along with him, and he began to be deeply distressed and troubled. "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow, to the point of death," he said to them. "Stay here and keep watch." Going a little farther, he fell to the ground and prayed that, if possible, the hour might pass from him. "Abba, Father," he said, "everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will." The inner three, we could call them, were Peter, James, and John. They were the closest friends of Jesus. Imagine being that close to this teacher, this leader, this healer, this saviour, about whom 1,990 years later we are still talking. The memories of such a character would live long in the memories. Perhaps they would recall that garden, the time of night. Was it early in the evening when they started? Had dusk already come hours before? And they were wondering, why was Jesus heading out to Gethsemane at such a time? Were the lights of the city helping them find their steps on their familiar journey? The images painters have created of the memorable scene generally have dark skies around. Whatever the time of day, light or dark, this was a dark night for the soul. Jesus was distressed and troubled. He was overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death, and he fell to the ground and prayed. It's worthy of a pause to reflect on how this gracious, loving, serving Son of God felt in that moment. Whatever we are facing today or tomorrow or in this season of life, take comfort from the fact that our Lord Jesus faced a great and imminent danger, and he too seems to have pushed his Heavenly Father for an answer. And judging by the prayer and the outcome, he did not receive the one for which he seems to have hoped. "Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will. Whatever we are facing today or tomorrow, or in this season of life, take comfort from the fact that our Lord Jesus faced a great and imminent danger, and he too seems to have pushed his heavenly Father for an answer, and he did not receive the one for which he seems to have hoped. We'll come back to this story next Monday and hear the disappointment of Jesus and his three best friends as the tale unfolds. Let us pray today for all who face various trials, various kinds of event ahead of them, both those who know what is coming and the rest of us who don't. And we pray that they may hear the words of Jesus as told in Revelation 2, verse 10. Do not be afraid of what you're about to suffer. Be faithful even to the point of death, and I will give you life as your victor's crown. Lord, we pray for men and women who have nailed their colours to the cross and now face persecution and victimisation in the workplace, in their homes, within their communities, and even in the courts. In times of trouble, Lord, help us trust you and not be afraid. Lord Jesus, we remember before you those whose faith is shaken as they see troubles affecting others for whom they have prayed and for whom they care. In times of trouble, Lord, help us trust you and not be afraid. Lord Jesus Christ, as your disciples saw your example and learnt how close you were to your heavenly Father, help us to model a similar affinity with God, our Father, and so draw strength from him as we lean on him. In times of trouble, Lord, help us trust you and not be afraid. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, we beg your mercy and help for all who are facing life-threatening illnesses. And we remember those whose fear of the virus is making them mentally ill, and those for whom lockdown and the threat of lockdown is proving disastrous to their happiness. Help and heal them, we pray, and bless the medical and psychological teams who seek to offer aid. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Thank you for joining us today, Saturday. I hope that tomorrow, Sunday, you're able to come together to worship the Lord either at St Andrew's at 12 o'clock for our regular service or at 10 o'clock at St Ignatius in Carriduff, where we're having a short general vestry meeting and then about 5 minutes later having a harvest themed service. You'll recall you've been encouraged to support this in lots of ways, a harvest appeal to help defray some of the downturn in money we received over the lockdown period. A shoebox with Christmas, Operation Christmas Child gifts within it, and also some food for the larder. I'm sure you can do one or even two of those three things as part of your support of the harvest. God bless you, and thank you for listening this morning.